Hey, hi guys, welcome. So today we are going to share one of the important concept of Java, or you can say one of the important interview questions that is asked in every Java interview. So what is singleton design pattern? So basically singleton pattern, you can answer it this way, like singleton pattern restricts the instantiation of a class and ensures that only one instance of the class exists in the JVM. So, and remember, singleton in Java and singleton in Spring are, there is a bit difference, and it is better to know about that as well. So in Java, it is one instance, like one instance of a class per JVM it is present, and in Spring it is a bit different, and whenever we are explaining that thing, I'll talk about that thing as well. So how can we, so after the, after giving the theoretical what I can say description of singleton design pattern, the next question obviously would be how to create a singleton class in Java. So we can create singleton class in Java by having a private constructor, a private static variable which holds the instance variable, and a public static default like get instance method which will create the object and return the object. So let us see how can we do that. So basically singleton can be created like this as well, right? So why do we need constructors and all those things directly? Have a private static singleton class ref, and this is an instance, instance. So we can have this, have a private constructor, singleton class constructor. So have a private constructor, have a public get instance method. This method is a static method again. So public static, and can we do this directly? Return instance, and directly here I can create the object. So with this thing we can even say that only one thread can act, no matter how many threads act, only one instance will be created, as because this code gets executed when the class is getting loaded itself. So what the issue here is, even if nobody wants the object of the singleton class, even then in that scenario the object is getting created. So that is not the expected way our code should work. Only if at all someone is requesting, at that time only our object should get created. This is also known as eager eager instantiation or eager object creation, we can say. And there is one more way as well, we can have a static block here, and same logic can be written inside the static block, and we can return the instance directly. But again, there is also the issue is the static block gets executed at the time of class loading itself, and again an eager initialization will happen. So that is not what we want. So what we want, only whenever someone is requesting, at that time only we need our object, right? So what we can do here, directly we can have an if condition, check the instance if it is instantiated already or not. If it is not, then call the class on the constructor and return this. That's it, we are done. A singleton instance will be created here and it will be returned. But the issue here is the WoW implementation, that definitely this implementation works perfectly fine when it is only single threaded environment, but when it comes to multi-threaded environments it can cause reuse if multiple threads are inside that if condition. If multiple threads are here, that they have passed this check, then there can be multiple instances getting created of the singleton class, and the singleton pattern will get destroyed here. So how to, now we have to make this thread safe. How can we make thread safe? It is very simple. So we can directly have one synchronized keyword. We can create a synchronized block, synchronized block, and our issue is resolved. The multi-threading environment also, the only one thread will be acting upon this method, and the singleton pattern doesn't get destroyed. But here the issue is with performance. The performance get degraded, even though it is for the initial 1-2 threads, but still it will lock the entire object and it will create the performance. So to overcome this one, we can go with double check locking. So what is double check locking? I'll explain. Remove the synchronized keyword here. Here in this thing we can have two if checks. How? So we have one synchronized if. So firstly we'll check, then we will have one synchronized block. We can have one synchronized block, synchronized of this class. I hope everyone knows how to create a synchronized block. So we have a synchronized block, then again inside the synchronized block have one more if condition. This if condition instance, if inside this, then we can create our object creation can happen here. So now what will happen? Our issue got resolved. So the performance that used to have impact when we are having the synchronized method, now that gets eradicated. And this way, and this is a perfect way to create a singleton class. I won't say perfect way, but this is one of the best approaches to follow singleton design pattern, or say how to create a singleton class the best possible way. In the next section I will explain you how can we break this singleton pattern here. Just wait for the next section. So guys, we have created the singleton class. Now let us see how can we break this singleton prototype, like singleton functionality here. So I have created one class. Let me quickly copy that. There are n number of ways to break the singleton functionality. I am using reflection here to break it. So dot get instance, I'll get one instance of singleton class. Now copy paste as to make that. So I'm creating, calling singleton class again. Let's sys out this s1 S1 and S2, but let us have the hash code and let's run this. Now see, if you notice, both have printed the same hash code. That means only one instance variable has been created. Now let us see how can we break. So to break it, see what I'll do. Class, okay, let me take one dot class dot get declared constructors. So this will return the declared constructors. So constructors equals, let us create a local variable. This is of type singleton class. So typecast is here as well. So we got the constructors now. Now I'll iterate through each constructor. And let us create a loop variable. Okay, the constructor we got dot set accessible to true. Now see the magic. Now I'm reassigning the s2 to constructor dot new instance. Okay, and now I'll print this s2 dot hash code, throws exception. Okay, Now see what will happen. See the magic. Boom! The new hash code has been printed with for S2. That means there are two instance variables now. Now how can we resolve this? How can we solve this? So one of the easiest and the quickest way is have one if condition here. But this is debatable, or we can do in any way. We can have an enum here, or we can do this. If this is not null, then directly throw an exception. Throw new exception at throws. So let me create one message here, not allowed. So wherever we are using the constructor, at all those places we need to throw no handle bits. So directly throw. Now run the same code and see what will happen. Boom, we got to one instance, same hash code getting printed. Now when we try to create a new instance directly using reflection, we got the exception saying not allowed. This is one of the way we can do, and this is, as I said, this is debatable. We can directly have an enum here and we can solve this issue. And the other ways using how singleton functionality can be break of this class is using serializable. When we serialize and when we deserialize it, the singleton functionality will be broken here. So to handle that, in serialization and deserialization, we need to override one method called read resolve. So if you are overriding the read resolve and calling that get instance method, then the issue will be resolved. And in the clone, using cloning also, we can break this functionality. And in that scenario, whenever the clone method is called, we need to override the clone method and we need to throw an exception from the clone method saying that clone is not allowed. And we can resolve that in that way. And that's it. Let me format. That's it for in this video. I hope you liked it. Just one thing I have explained it. If you want the other ways how to break and make singleton, or if you want that scenarios as well, you can comment it out in the comment section. I'll create a video on that as well. So to keep it short, I have shown you one example. There are few other examples as well. And thank you for watching.